Dear students, today I am going to discuss about the summary of mutex as well as semaphore. Already I have covered the video series of semaphore and mutex in my earlier series. However, in these connections, I feel that this interprocess communication and synchronizations, along with the remaining metaphors and semaphore, will give you a better clarity in this video series. Hence, I carry out these discussions based on the written content. In the interprocess communication and synchronizations, the first point is the discussion on the multiprogramming. Multiprogramming allows multiprocessor to run concurrently. Concurrently, as the name indicates, that it runs or it's the act of managing and running multiple processor or multiple computations at the same time. That means if you take an example like talking and eating, you cannot talk and eat simultaneously, but you can talk and eat one after another. So that is the state of a concurrency. So in the multiprogramming allows multiprocessor to run concurrently one after other, even on a system with a single CPU. Even if it is a single CPU, it follows the same concurrent behavior. Application developer, for example, software. If we take a consideration of a hardware and a software approach, in the software approach as well as in the hardware approach, which is based on the interrupt handling, they take the advantage of the concurrent capability, where you will find that the software is better as compared to the hardware approach, whereas because the software has more dynamic flexibility to carry out the concurrent effectively based on the signaling conditions. Whereas this is in the hardware forms, you don't have a flexibility to change the requirement as on when needed. File writing is by one process, file reading by another process, maybe concurrent or not, is an inter-process communication. File writing, say for example, let me take a case like this, is that a person is writing a text here that see me at 10 a.m. And at the same time, when the person is reading and the second person try to alter this one to say 11 a.m. So that means the first phase of reading is one process and writing is another process. When the reading is going on, at that time the writing should not occur. Otherwise, the person will not able to read and write the things in a proper manner. Rather, it will try to overlap. He may not be certain that what is exactly the text. So that is what it indicates, that the file writing by one process and the file reading by another process may be concurrent or not. Is just process communications. Now, process synchronizations. Process synchronizations using a multiprocess operating systems. Now, under this particular case, I have taken a consideration of a procedure and a consumer process code. Now, what exactly the procedure process code? Procedure process code is something like you are writing something, or you are giving something in the process. And consumer process code is something who is taking that particular from the process and using it. Just like I have used a particular programming sequence like while one, while counter is equal to n, if counter is equal to n, the next items is taken to the buffer. That means here in the case of the process synchronizations, we use a methods by means of which we take the input to the buffer, and thereby from the buffer we take it to the output. So this particular sequence is called as a buffering. So for example, let me put it like this one. We take a buffer puts like this, and from this the producer, we take a producer here. Producer is putting the process one after another. Suppose say 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So the first process will, if this is a output, this is a input, the producer put the first process here, first process, second process, third process, fourth process, fifth process. If I am putting the partition 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, but the order will be like this. So the first process will be coming out. So this will be consumer. This is a consumer. This is consuming whatever is there in the buffer. And this producer is this one. It is putting all the process in a queue. This is a queue. It is in a queue. So in the queue, all the process is being placed. That is what it in media. So producer. Process process. So you are taking a counter, and the next item is taken to buffer 1. Now here in IN plus 1 mod N, that means whatever is the input here, if it is plus 1 and if it is divided by the mod N, it will be equal to the what is the next value. Suppose here you are taken a 5, and here input is say the fifth item, 5 plus 1 6. 6 mod 5 is what is equal to 1. So that is how this calculation is, and after that the counter is incremented. So this is the producer is keep on adding the items, whereas if you see the consumer side, it is a counter is equal to 0. Whatever item is to be taken, it is taken from the buffer out. You see here it is written as buffer out, here it is taken as a buffer in. So in the buffer out it is going on. So out is equal what? Out is equal to out plus 1 mod n. So sometime mod n, out plus 1 mod n is written like out plus 1 percentage n. So this is also, it is represented as a mod n. So that is what out plus 1 mod n. And this counter is decrementing. So consumer is consuming every time it is decrementing. So this is what the process synchronization. Process synchronization should be there between producer and consumer. That means if a producer is putting a 5 input, the consumer has to consume the 5 outputs. Otherwise, this will be blocked. So that's if normally if it is arrives in the case of a particular process, we termed it as deadlock. So that deadlock situations we should not permit. So that is what it is termed. The next point of a discussion is about critical section. Critical section means the section of a code that requires access to shared resource are called critical section. Section of the codes that requires access to shared resource are called. So critical, suppose a process is running. This is a process P1 and it is occupying a resource. There are memory input output. This is occupied by this process. Now the next process P2 is coming. Now P2 wants also to access this resource, but this is already occupied by this one. So what will happen? This process will have to decide whether to permit to give it to P2 or not. So if this is under critical region or a critical section, so the section of the code that required to access this resource are called critical section. After the critical sections, when it ends, the next process will be able to carry on. The next point of a discussion is mutual exclusions. Mutual means here I have clearly specified mutual is between if a two party, there is a mutual discussions between the two parties, so that is called as a mutual. And exclusion is that if this process is, this person is, say for example, is very hungry and he is eating something. So this process is making this person not to disturb him and until he finish eating this one, or it is making this process to bar off or barring. So exclusions means barring. The mutual exclusions means between the mutual exclusion, the one process will be barring the other process. It is a critical requirement of OS. It is a critical requirement of operating system and is a part of a numerous resource. What are resource? File, input, output, data sharing, like memory management, all these things. So if a P access a resource R, no other process can access R. So if this one is accessing this resource R, then P2 cannot access R. That is what it indicates. There are three approach for the mutual exclusions. What are these three approach? First is that software approach. Leave the responsibility to process itself, which is error prone, likely to suffer, and high overhead. That means if you are using a software approach, you can able, and if there is a multi-programming, you can able to solve this particular software approach to allow which process, if there is a multiple process is running, which process to wait, which process to act, and which process should take the resource at what time, and which process should release its time so that the other process can utilize that particular resource. All this management is being carried out under the software approach. And there are chances that it is error prone, that it may sometime get stuck because of the multiple programming technique. There are chances. That is what is called as leave the responsibility. And this responsibility is given to the process to decide itself. How the process will decide? The process will decide based on the programming. So based on the programming, if the process decide, and if any times, if the deadlock occurs, this particular situation. That means, say for example, there are three boys, and every boy is given a certain task to carry out, and if this person is given the three different tasks, and that task, these three tasks has to fit to this particular project. That means task 1, task 2, task 3. I put it as 1, 2, 3. If there is an error in this task, this project will not run. So that is the thing, is that these three programming or has to go effectively for this particular project to execute. So this is, if it is just left to individuals and ask the individual to bring and put it over here, their program, and to run, it may occur that the process may sometime get hang up. So that is what, this is the first approach. The second approach which is being shared is the hardware approach. Hardware approach is based on the interrupt handling. So there are chances that it is faster, but we cannot avoid the deadlock situations. We cannot avoid, and starvation means, suppose, say for example, if a process P1 is running, P2 is running, P2 is running and P3 is waiting. If these two processes running for a long time, P3 will be waiting, and what will happen? It will go for a starving conditions. So that is what it is. Now second is that third method is a programming language. The programming language method is that in which we are using a semaphore, monitor, and a message passing technique to solve this concurrency problems. So that is what being used in the case of a mutual exclusions. So in nutshell, the discussion of the concurrency and synchronization is basically essential in the case of a operating system, is that one, so that CPU cannot be put under the condition in an ideal state. CPU utilizations has to increase. If the CPU utilization has to increase, we should not make that one process, if it is running, that means it should run for a longer period. If this process is using certain resource for a longer period, then the other process will be in the starving conditions. Second process will go into starving conditions. So what you do, you run the process for a certain time, and based on the criterion or the management criterion, you can allow this particular resource to be used by P2. And after that, you can take back that resources. All this management will give effectiveness in creating a better utilization of the CPU. Thank you.